Hey guys, I'm here to talk about classic gaming controllers. More specifically, 8bitdo's NES30. It is a Bluetooth controller that works on Windows, Mac, iOS, Android, and actually if you load a legacy firmware, it'll work on Raspberry Pi, which is really cool. So it communicates over Bluetooth 4.0 or by the USB. So while you plug it in USB to your PC, not only will it charge it, but it will pass information. So that is pretty important. It's on PC, it supports the X input button mapping, so you kind of are able to use it with a lot of games right off the bat, which is nice. Who is this for? So I would say, you know, this is obviously for somebody who appreciates old design aesthetics. It's modeled after Nintendo's classic NES design. So, you know, it's really trying to pull at those heartstrings if you grew up like me playing old Nintendo. So it's also for people who do not like the batch of controllers that are out there. I've personally tested some of them. You know, I've got a couple real cheap knockoffs here. And the biggest problem with a lot of these crappy controllers is typically the buttons. The NES30 by 8bitdo actually has a pretty good button feel. It's got a little bit more click to it than the traditional gamepads, which actually I have here. Not only do I have the original, I also do have the NES Classic, which got released last year. And between the two, you know, I'm sure there's tons of comparisons out there. The D-pad's a little squishier, but still pretty stiff. And then the buttons have a nice click to them, especially the start and select. On something like this crappy one, this knockoff, the D-pad is real stiff, and if you can kind of hear, these have a real unsatisfying thunk to them, and the depth that you have to press for the button to trigger is just real bad, especially start and select. They're really raised up in there. On the 8bitdo though, it is pretty damn good. Like I said, the D-pad's a little more clickier than what's on the original Nintendo, but that's actually fine for me. And the actual face buttons have a good satisfying click too. Start and select, a little taller than the original, but still feel pretty good. So the biggest thing, as you can tell, is that they've actually added some extra buttons. There's two extra face buttons and two extra shoulder buttons here at the top. This is for them to kind of have compatibility with games other than NES games. And that's really my main problem I have with this. The design, top notch. The feel and the quality, top notch. I really love the care that they put into this, especially in the packaging too. It looks real nice. But at the end of the day, this NES controller does not play NES games that great. You know, I've played hundreds of hours of NES games throughout my life, and my brain is hardwired to have the A and B button side by side. And when I'm sitting there, you know, trying to play Castlevania and I get into the rhythm of things, I just want to go left and right. It was really hard for me to wrap my brain around the face buttons here. So, yeah. And then the other end of it, you know, how does it work on something like Super Nintendo, which, you know, it has all the buttons that you would need for that. Once again, not quite great. The shoulder buttons are kind of awkwardly placed. I traditionally like to hold this gamepad like this, so that means I either need to trigger the shoulder buttons by the elbow of my finger, if you will, or I have to rotate my hand out like this, and that's not comfortable. So, like I said, not great to play NES games with this, and not great to play SNES games with this. So, in my opinion, I would much rather have had 8bitdo make a really great NES controller first and foremost. But I can understand at a price point of around like $32 is what you can find this for, that they wanted something a little more versatile. Sure, I get it. I really do, but once again, I kind of wanted something that had that classic look and feel of an NES controller when I'm emulating NES games, but have, you know, the functionality there too. It's just the for whatever reason the button placement was really holding me back. So unfortunately, I'm giving this a score of 3 out of 5. As my final verdict. Definitely something to look into if you're unlike me and not worried about the button placement. It is, like I said, solidly built. It also comes in the Famicom, the NES30, the Famicom styling from the Japanese variant, which is really nice, but I never had a Famicom, so I have more of the affinity for the old classic NES. So yeah, that's my review and I'm sticking to it. Cool.